It was strange. It's as you know, it's not natural hearing. That first journey home in the car, I was driving and I went to turn into the road to drop my mum off, and I could hear this tick, 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 and it was the indicator of the car. I mean, my mum got so excited. It was so lovely. It was lots of beepy noises, and to start with, voices sounded a bit like Mickey Mouse on helium, really. It was high-pitched and very quite tinny and quite robotic as well.
In the initial switch-on, 6 weeks after the implantation, Connor switched on. We noticed him respond. The sound was set very low, but it was we knew, me and our dad knew initially when that happened, he responded. And he responded just by a very slight movement of the head, but it was very clear that he had heard.
When the implant was first switched on, it sounded very, very strange. My first thought was, there's things going on inside my head. It feels like there's a sound inside my head, which I'd never really experienced before, because hearing aids just don't work that way. And that was just an incredibly new sensation that took a little while to get used to. It wasn't a bad sensation, it was just interesting and different. The sound quality that I had at the time, it actually felt quite poor when I was first switched on. I was expecting this because throughout the whole process when I was being assessed, one message that I heard several times from people at the implant centre was, it would sound terrible when it's first switched on. And so my expectation is that it'd be managed, and it did sound terrible when it's first switched on.
Those first 48 hours can be a little bit like, oh my God, is it going to be like this forever? But you do need to look beyond it.